Do your team members ever overreact? We've discussed the three parts of a full thought: stimulus, connected fact, associated emotion. Our analogy is like a squirrel going from tree to tree. Each tree in our brain represents a word. If I smell grass, my squirrel scampers to the trunk of the grass tree and reaches the branches, which are the connected facts, such as mowing and summer. If the squirrel jumps from the mowing branch on the grass tree to the grass branch on the mowing tree, I will experience an unhappy emotion. If the person finishes this full thought, they might say, "Oh, I don't want to mow the yard. What a drain." But what if the person smelled grass and then started crying? What happened? What if the squirrel didn't come all the way down to the ground from the mowing tree, which would have completed the full thought, but rather jumped to another connecting tree? That connecting fact and associated emotion, the mowing and unhappy emotion, can become the stimulus for the next thought. When the squirrel jumped to the mowing tree and experienced unhappiness, the squirrel ran to another branch on the mowing tree, the cat branch, for example, and jumped from the cat branch on the mowing tree to the mowing branch on the cat tree, and the associated emotion they felt was sadness. Why? Because when she was little and helping her dad mow the yard, their cat ran in front of the mower and got injured. This is a complex thought. It's when one full thought becomes the stimulus for another thought. Your squirrel can jump from tree to tree to tree very quickly, and it can be very confusing for others why the person is experiencing an emotion that doesn't seem logical to the first stimulus. And it can be tempting to make assumptions such as they're overly dramatic or too emotional. Recently, our home team was watching a movie. At one point, we all started laughing and our daughter got upset and yelled that it wasn't funny. We asked her why she was upset. She said one of the characters made her mad. I realized her squirrel must have jumped a few trees to get to where she was upset. So I asked her if the character reminded her of anyone, and she shared that it reminded her of a boy in her class. I asked if the character did anything that the boy in her class did. As we kept following the path of her squirrel, we learned that the boy in her class had done a similar thing as the character in an effort to make our daughter look bad in front of her friends. So, are you ready to help all your teams break down complex thoughts to further understand and help them? If you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe to stay connected. Thank you for letting me share my leadership thought. Have a great week.